Now in this video we will see what is redux persist, okay, and why we will use this redux persist. So redux persist, like I have created doc. So redux persist is a library that allows saving a redux store in a local storage of in applications. Means in by the help of this redux persist library, we save our state in a local storage. Okay. Means it's saving a redux store. Like redux is a container, state container, and we have a state here. So we generally save our state in the local storage and fetch from there. Like I have an example here, like this. Okay, when I am just increasing my count, okay, I'm increasing my count and I refresh, then this count, after refreshing my page, this count will not be show for. It will be refresh and it will be show here zero. Okay, so this is the initial value of this count is zero. Like I'm just refreshing, so now this is zero. Okay, but by the help of redux persist, we will save this count into the local storage, and after refreshing, this will not reset to the zero. This will be the remain four. Okay, and if you want to get a video of the redux flow and the redux thanks, you can go to the my channel and you can subscribe my channel, and I have also created this beautiful videos of redux flow and redux thunk. Okay, so now let's do it. How we can, first we will do the configurations. Like here, first we will install the library redux persist. I'm just going here and I will install here npm install redux persist. Okay, like this. It will take some time, this will take some time, so I'm just going to pause my video. So meanwhile, so now our redux persist library installed here by npm install redux persist. So redux persist, we will do some settings in our store file. So we will go into the store like this here, and I will just import here persist store and persist reducer. Okay, we will persist our reducer, and by the help of this persist reducer we will persist our store. Okay, so now I will just import storage, this library is just used for the store our state in the local storage. Okay, and how we will store our data in the local storage, on some key we just store our data in local storage. So I am just creating a configuration here. Here is a key on which we will save our data. We will save our data persist key. Okay, you can have anything, any name you can have here. Like persist key I'm having, you can have persist store and anything you can have. And second, we will have this storage. Okay, now we will create our persist storage reducer. Okay, first argument will be this configuration. On this configuration we will save our root reducer here. Okay, root reducer is here, so we will save here like this. Okay, now I will assign into a root, not persisted reducer. Okay, so persisted reducer is created, and then I will replace the root reducer by the persisted reducer. Okay, so now I will create a persisted store by, I will pass here, like in the create store we have passed here. So I have a persist store In that persist store, I will pass this store. Okay. Persister. I am assigning in a variable like persister. So now this store is not persisted and this is persisted store. So I will export this as well. So like export like this. Okay. I have exported this and I will import this. Now I have created one store, persisted store, and I will just like this, as we have this store, we have make available to our application. So I will make available this persisted store in the same way. Like I will go into the index.file like this. We have imported here a store, so we will import here a persisted store here. And after the help of the provider, now we have provided the store to the React application. Now we will provide this persisted store as well. So I will import here, import, there is a persist get from React persist slash, it will integrate it will use for integration with React. Okay, not in capital, small. React hyphen persist hyphen integration React. So now this persist gate, in the same way as we are providing our store to the app, in the same way we will create a parent of here, and we will pass here persister like this. Okay, now our setting is done. So what persist get is do here? Persist get just delay the response till the our state will save. Meanwhile, our state is saved in the local storage, and we will fetch from there. In this duration, the persist store just delay the response and delay the rendering of the component. So and this is also providing the persister store to our React application. Okay, so let's see. React persist integration module not found. We are getting this issue. This is not React, this is Redux. Okay, Redux. Okay, so this was the mistake here. I'm just going to refresh. Redux persist. Okay, and this import, this will be the, this is not export default, so we will use like this, and now issue resolved. Now I am just going to incrementing. So this count for should not be zero. After refreshing, I am refreshing. Now this is not changing. Okay, superb. So we have done. Now you can see this, I'm refreshing, but this is not changing. So I'm just going into the application, and in the local storage, we have here in this, you can see in the local storage, in the persist key, you can see the value change count 6. As I'm increasing this change count, our reducer value is changing here. Okay, when I'm reducing, then this is also changing. Okay, like this. This is working fine. Okay, so I'm just going to my documentation. So Redux persist is the library allow saving the Redux store into the local. So we have stored in the local storage on some key. Okay, like here, if I just delete this from the local storage and refresh, then this will be reset to the zero. Again, this is saving here to the, this is also saving here in the local storage. Okay, so going to the dock. So what we have do there, the step we have followed, we have installed the Redux persist library. After that, we have configured in the store. We have just in the Redux persister, in the Redux persist, we have fetched our two functions like persist store and persist reducer. We will first create the persist reducer. Okay, and we have also used the storage library to save our data in the local storage. So there is a configurations like in the persist root, we have used here persist key. Okay, in this key we will save our reducer. Okay, root reducer. So in persist reducer, we have passed configurations, and after that second parameter root reducer, we have created a persist reducer. And in the create store, we have passed this persist reducer, and after that in apply middleware, this is the Redux thunks, and here we have created the persist store persister. Okay, we have passed this store. After that, we have created a persist gateway. Persist gateway delay the rendering of your API UI until your persist state has been retrieved and saved to the Redux. Okay, so here in the same way we provide the store to our application, we have provided the persister store to our application. So this is all about the all settings. So this you will get this document in my Telegram group. So thank you for watching. Please subscribe my channel.